For our final candidate is Jane Cook. She will be speaking about an exploration of an interprofessional education in health and social care.
Thank you. Good afternoon. So, when professionals fail to work collaboratively within healthcare settings, lives are lost. The mid-staffs and real leaving inquiries are hard-hitting examples of what happens when collaboration breaks down and people die. So if we take diabetes, for example, which is a very complex disorder, up to 20% of people in hospital at any one time will have diabetes, and they're supported by a vast amount of healthcare workers. And they can be in contact, a person living with diabetes can be in contact with up to 15 different healthcare workers. So what does that mean in terms of safe delivery of diabetes services? It means that collaboration is an absolute necessity. But how do we ensure that people collaborate to save lives? How do we ensure they work interprofessionally? Well, we educate to collaborate. We educate through developing and delivering interprofessional education. Now, interprofessional education is where two or more healthcare professionals will learn with, from and about each other to improve collaboration and quality of care. In simple terms, it's learning together, communicating, networking and collaborating. But what does that mean in reality? Well, there's an imperative for educational institutes to develop and deliver interprofessional education. But there's also a disconnect between education and the reality of practice within health and social care, and my research is exploring that concept. In interviews with healthcare professionals who are participating in a diabetes education programme, so practice nurses, GPs, dietitians and podiatrists, it's emerging that they feel they are learning together, but this is happening informally within their break times, coffee time and lunch time. And when I propose the more formal definition of interprofessional education, they tend to huddle under its umbrella, conforming to that and forgetting about the richness of these informal elements. And this conformity is quite common in healthcare. In fact, it's been described as potentially deadly and responsible for bad practice and poor quality of care. So if we take lack of collaboration, conformity and a lack of consensus, we might have what appears to be a deadly combination. So what's the answer? Is it as simple as blathering together at coffee time, chatting together? Do we try and inform our policies with this most basic form of communication and come out from underneath the umbrella to collaborate? It is time to reach a consensus and to try and develop an interprofessionally focused curriculum that will deliver collaborative graduates who are actually ready to deliver care that saves lives. Thank you.